as we welcome in our pal Joe Convertino Jr. from CH Insurance for our Cup of Joe. Hey, Joe, good morning. How are you?
Good morning, Gomez. Happy Wednesday.
Happy. Hey, halfway to the weekend. We're getting there. Go Orange.
And I think I think it's an Orange week and weekend coming up, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. And I think here at the Rock and Roll Radio Ranch, tomorrow, we've been encouraged to wear our orange as well. So, yeah, like from here right through Saturday night's game, that 9:55 tip.
It's going to be great. Hey, Gomez, I got to ask you a question. Did you shoot it like Buddy in the old days?
No. I've never done anything like Buddy in the old days. I'm trying to think of nothing.
Even in the new days.
Hey, on top of just the way he's been playing, obviously, and through work here, every now and then we do get a chance to bump into Buddy, and obviously coach
right.
quite frequently. He's just a good kid. He's just a nice young man. It's great to see that he's playing well, obviously, but to see the national attention that he's getting, and that now people actually get a chance to see him as just a great young man.
I really believe that. I mean, you're getting to know him more, even though kind of we're all local and know him, but on a national level, I mean, he's saying great things, giving all the teammates credit, and it's just so true. I mean, it's going to be a great weekend, I think. Couple more W's, and we get to the Final Four.
Hey, it's doable this year. And you know what? Why not? They're playing well, and anything can happen in the tournament, but they just seem to be playing their best basketball at the exact right time of the year. So, go Orange.
I agree.
Joe, I wanted to run one by you here. A couple of topics to talk about, but this one has to do with, and I didn't know this was a thing. It was a wedding. It was one of those destination weddings. I don't know if it was in the Caribbean or Hawaii or whatever, but at the wedding, the bride's, I'll preface this, was no one was injured. But the bride's dress caught fire. The husband was able to get the dress off her and throw it in the ocean to put the fire out. But they then, because the wedding dress is expensive, and because I think she had like bumped into something the hotel had provided, they had to sue the insurance provider for the hotel for the cost of the wedding dress. I'd never heard of such a thing.
Wow. Wow. So yeah, well, if the the people that hosted the wedding, obviously at a hotel or resort, if the fire was caused by something they did, obviously their liability policy because of the property damage of that dress would have been she probably got a new dress, and the husband saved the place from burning down, so he did the right thing and threw her in the water to put out the fire.
But is wedding insurance, that's a real thing then?
Oh, yeah. Good question. Time of year coming up, spring, post-pandemic, I'm sure there's going to be a ton of weddings coming up. But what your listeners need to know, there is wedding insurance. A lot of couples, Gomez, get married at barns, backyards, beaches, destinations that don't ultimately have like a hotel where they'd have all this insurance. So if you're going to an individual place or vacant land with an old warehouse, you know, all these types of scenarios today that kids are getting married, you could take out wedding insurance policy for, I don't know, $300-$400, but it also covers the liability of people on the premise. But most weddings have food and alcohol, and you know what happens in the alcohol world. So,
true.
You know, it would cover them if they got sued, you know, where people do leave the wedding and drive home and God forbid something happens. So, you know, take a peek. It's not covered on your homeowners. It's a separate policy that you have to talk to your agent about.
Wow. Look at all we've learned here today.
Yeah, no.
And I had a question here from text of people who are tuning in, Joe. They want to know about data breach. Is there an insurance? If you're a business, can you get insurance if you get if your stuff gets broken into digitally?
Yes. What that's really called? You might have heard the term cyber insurance or data breaches, things of that nature. A lot of employers are staying awake at night wondering, you know, can it happen to them? You remember years ago, Target, I think Excellus had a breach 2-3 years ago. Yeah. The insurance, Gomez, helps pay people to get their information back restored. Okay. Knowing you guys, like even me and my dad, we get emails all the time saying, click this, you want a free Starbucks gift card.
Sure.
Okay. So the most vulnerable, really, people at any business is your employees, because we're clicking things and on email every day. And if you click something, that allows a hacker to get into your system and do all types of stuff. So think about it. If you're a bank, if you take credit cards, things of that nature, you know, you got to be careful. And insurance for this would be similar. $1 million of coverage, deductible, and it protects you from those things if you got hacked and even lost your reputation, because that gets out on the street. It would help do all that to get your business back to where you need to be.
Got it. Again, look at all we've learned today from
Joe
Comerchino Jr.
You're getting dangerous. I love it. We might want to hire you.
Wow, look at that. Hey, Joe, great cup of Joe this week. We'll chat here very soon, and before long, we'll be out on the golf course.
You got it. Have a great week, and go Orange.